today we are going to draw this cute unicorn. It's actually really simple to draw, and you only need these stuff. HB pencil, some Crayola Pipsqueak markers, a netted eraser. Any normal eraser works fine, I just prefer the netted eraser. And a Sharpie pen or a Sharpie. So, let's get started. Start off with the ear. It's kind of like a diamond, except a bit more curly. Okay, so, and now just add the shadow. Okay, and now let's do a bit of the hair. Make like a curvy line. Bring it up. And up. And up. And now give it a point and lift it all the way up. Add another lock. One more lock. And another, tie it behind the ear. And then from the ear, add another lock. Going down. Another lock down, just more and more until finally you can bring it to a point and go from behind the ear and draw a line and then draw another and gracefully bring it to an end. Okay. Now for the head. Make like a line. And the snout is going to be pointing down. You draw the line and then you draw kind of like a straight line and connect it and create a smile. Okay, and then make another line and connect it down up here to complete the head. Maybe you can fix this line up a bit. Okay, make a circle for the eye, crescent shape, lines. And the two pupils, maybe draw some eyelashes. Okay, and then draw the nostril. Fix this up. Yes. Okay, and now some more hair, like here, curved line. This is for more hair. And then draw another lock, another one. Finally, hair, and another one. Okay. And then that brings us to the body. Okay, make that easier. Okay, follow the hairline and make a long line going down. Okay, and that brings to the first leg. Starting from nearly the lock of the hair, draw the first leg. It should be kind of curved. And go a little bit to the side. And draw kind of curved. Not really. Bring it down. Even more curve. Okay. And more slanted diagonal. And then line going down here, line down here, a wide one, a straight one going up, and a wavy one going up, and then another line connecting it there to draw another hook. Okay, now the rest of the body. Skirt will be next. Draw another curved line. This is for belly. Not that long, but fix that later. Curved line. Okay. And then draw the back leg. Slant it. Draw another line down. And then the hoof. And then a kind of slanted line. And then use that line to draw the rest. Of the horse's body. Okay. Maybe this is a bit too fat here, the leg, so fix it according to your taste. Okay, and now the tail. Make a wavy line down. Another line here, third one here, that one going down to create a tip and a curve and another line, and finally the end. Okay, and maybe this go a bit more up. It up a bit. Okay. And the tent, I mean the wings. Okay. So start by drawing a curved line all the way up to the neck. And start drawing kind of like a leaf shape. Point it towards the top. And then bring it down and connect it there. Okay, now let's draw the one on the other side. Draw the topmost leaf there, the other one, and that one up there. Okay, the horn belongs up here. Okay, and draw the curved lines, and now you're done, and you can trace everything. So one more thing I forgot to mention was that you're going to need to draw the last leg down there when I drew some designs on the wing. So the last leg would be slanted line down here, another slanted line down here, and then a curved line, hoof, and alright, and you can draw the ground. And then the hill. I should stand in front of it. Okay, draw some flowers. Colors we're going to use: Timberwolf, Cheddar Chip, Small Fry Yellow, Petal Pink, Pinky Pink, Petite Rose, and Grape Jam. So let's get started with the horn and color those silver. and maybe give it some of the light pink there, and maybe a bit the darker pink or a shadow. Okay, and now the hair is going to be petite rose. And now I use grape jam for a shadow. Okay, and then you're going to use the lighter pink of the two to color in the ear. And then we're going to use petal pink to give the shadow here. So okay, and now the tail and the rest of the hair, once again in the light purple. So I just serve another shadow. Okay, and then use the light pink once again, petite pink, to fully color the belly. Okay, now the wings are going to be really simple. Use the small bright yellow to color every other part. And then the darker one for shadow. And then the light pink here. Darker pink once again as a shadow. That brings us to the face. Use a light pink to color that portion a little bit. And the smile. Okay, if you'd like to color the eyes a blue. Okay, and so to finish it off, I added green for the grass and purple for the hooves and some pink and yellow for the flowers. And your unicorn is done. Please like and subscribe if you want more. Thank you.